Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about the numerical 2 on buck converter. Okay. So let us read the numerical. A buck converter is operating at 2 kilohertz. Okay, so let us first note F is equal to 2 into 10 to the power 3 hertz, right? This is given. Okay. Next, from 100 volt DC source, supply voltage is given. It is equal to 100 volt. Next, it has L by R ratio. L by R is equal to 6 milliseconds. 6 into 10 to the power minus 3 seconds. Okay. Next, the load resistance R is equal to, it is equal to 10 ohm. Next, find the mean load current. Okay. Our task is to find the mean load current, that is nothing but the average load current, right? Average load current, that is the I0 average. Mean is nothing but the average. Okay. Next, and magnitude of ripple current. Magnitude of ripple current means delta IL. We need to find. Next, for a load voltage of 50 volt, so V0, it is equal to constant. Okay. So V0 average they have given, it is equal to 50 volt. Okay. Next, also calculate maximum and minimum values of inductor current. Okay. In addition to this, we need to find IL mean and IL max. Okay. IL mean and IL max. Okay. These terms we find. Okay. So here, from this circuit, okay, so we are having the parameters given. We can write, first thing is we need to find the mean load current. Okay, mean load current, right? So here load resistance is given, it is a 10 ohm. Okay, so load voltage is given, it is a 50 volt, right? So therefore we can write mean load current, mean load current is equal to what? It is a I0 average, equal to V0 average, or V0 divided by R. What is the V0 average? It is a 50 divided by R. R is 10. So it is equal to 5 ampere, right? It is a 5 ampere. This is what? Mean load current, right? I0 average equal to 5 ampere. Is this clear? Right? So I0 average is 5 ampere, right? Next, second bit, we need to find the magnitude of ripple current, right? That is the delta IL we need to find. Okay, so before that, we know L by R is equal to 6 into 10 to the power minus 3, okay, seconds. Okay, so therefore L is equal to 6 into 10 to the power minus 3 into R, right? What is the R? R is given, it is a 10 ohm. So it is a 6 into 10 to the power minus 3 into 10. So it is equal to 60 into 10 to the power minus 3 Henry. This is the L value, right? Next, as this is the buck converter we are having, right? So for the buck converter, during T on, can we draw the circuit? Yes. During T on, that is a on time. Yes, we can draw the circuit like it is a VS, which is in the on state. We are having inductor, okay? We are having a circuit like this. During T on, which is closed, it is inductor we are having, right? Next, there it is a capacitor, it is a load. Load voltage is constant, load current is also constant. Load, this voltage is current is I0, the L voltage is this. Okay, so here this current is IL. Okay, now our task is to find delta IL, right? So during T on, can we apply KVL? Yes, KVL to loop we can write it as plus Vs minus L into dIL by dt, okay, minus V0 is equal to 0, okay. So here, what is the dIL? If you check the waveform, right, we already discussed about the operation, okay. If you check the waveform, the inductor current changes from I min to I max, okay. So we can write it as a plus Vs minus L into, yes, inductor current is changing from I min to I max. So what is the change in the current? It is a I max minus I min, okay, I max minus I min. So this can be written as I max minus I min, right? What is the change in the time? Time is changing, yes, from 0 to t on. So it is only t on. Minus V0 is equal to 0. Okay. So further, what is I max minus I min? It is a delta IL, right? So you can write Vs minus L into delta IL divided by t on, right? Is equal to what? V0, we can write, and I have shifted this V0 to the right hand side. Okay. So V0, right? Right. Next, we know Vs, we know V0, we know L. Yes, can we? Yes, can we find the T1? Right. T1 is equal to D into T. Okay. T1 is equal to D into T. So we can write it as T1 is nothing but D into T. Okay. So therefore, it is Vs minus L into delta IL divided by D into T is equal to V0. Okay. What is the D? Duty cycle. Right. We know supply voltage, we know load voltage. So can we find D? Yes, it is a Vs minus L into delta IL divided by D means what? It is a Vs by V0 by Vs, right? V0 is equal to D into Vs, right? So it is a V0 by Vs. That is nothing but D into T. T is nothing but 1 by frequency. Total time, okay, is equal to what? Okay. So from this, if we put Vs is 100 volt minus L, L is 60 millihenry, okay, 60 into 10 to the power minus 3. Next, into delta IL we need to find, divided by V0 by Vs, right? It is given that V0 is equal to 50 and Vs is 100, okay? So we can write it as 50 by 100. Can write it as a 50 by 100 into, yes, what is the 1 by f switching frequency is given, it is equal to 2 kilohertz, right? So it is a 1 by 2 into 10 to the power 3, okay, is equal to what? V0, sorry, V0 is also, we know V0 is equal to 50, right? V0 is equal to 50. From this, can we find the delta IL? Yes, we can find delta IL. That is the change in the inductor current, right? This clear? Okay. In this way, we can write the expression for the, or we can find the delta IL. Okay. So it is like 100 minus 50. Okay. Divided by. So it is 0.208. Delta IL equal to 0.2083 ampere. Okay, this is nothing but the delta IL, right? This is the delta IL. Okay, next they have asked for also calculate maximum and minimum values of inductor current. Okay, maximum and minimum values of inductor current. Okay, so if you check maximum and minimum value of inductor current, yes, recall the expressions, we can write IL max is nothing but what? I, or the load current I0, right? Plus delta IL by 2. Okay. So it is, what is I0? I0 is equal to, we have calculated it, 5 ampere, right? I0 is 5 ampere. You can write it as 5 ampere. Yes, we can write it as a 5 plus. Delta IL is 0.2083 divided by 2. Okay, so it is equal to it is a 5.104, 5.104 ampere. This is the IL max. What is the IL min? You can write it as a I0 minus delta IL by, okay, so is equal to 5 minus 0.208 divided by 2. What is the This is the IL mean. Are you getting the point? Okay. So this is about the numerical number 2 related to buck converter, right? In the next video, we are going to discuss about the third numerical. Thank you.